It's Friday, June 22nd, 2012. Let's talk PlayStation. As we all know from Sony's 2012 E3 press conference, Jack Tretton took the stage to announce Call of Duty Black Ops Declassified coming to the PlayStation Vita, but he didn't really tell us much about what it was going to be. He basically just came out on stage, announced that the game was coming, and gave us no other actual details. Well, Walmart.com and Amazon.com now has a product listing for the game, so now we have a little bit more details about the game, and we can go a little bit more off that for a jumping off point. Now, if we take a look at it, we get a box art, we get a little description, of course, we get a standard placeholder date for December 31st, which is usually always a placeholder date for most games that don't have any other grander information being attached to them, but we do have a description that we can go off of, which I'll be able to read to you right now. It says, before the future could be won, history had to be written. Exposing that story exclusively on PlayStation Vita, Call of Duty Black Ops Declassified explores original fiction in the Call of Duty Black Ops universe with an all-new campaign of special ops missions. Optimized for gamers on the go, Call of Duty Black Ops Declassified delivers the most intense handheld Call of Duty experience to date, including both special ops story mode and multiplayer combat tailored for the PS Vita. So, there's a few tidbits and things like that that we can draw from that. One thing being, well, we get those special ops modes that were included in previous entries in the franchise, and those are certainly exciting modes. I definitely enjoy them for sure. That would be a pretty nice fitting place on the handheld. I mean, this is going to be a very important game for Vita, because Vita isn't really doing all that well right now. Sony needs big, marquee titles to be released for the system so they can move more units. And Call of Duty, if you didn't realize, is kind of a big deal for some people. It's a big, big game. And, the real major concern here is that, well, we know Activision is publishing the game, obviously, but we don't know who's developing this game. And I would really hope that Activision is keeping a close eye on this game and making sure that it's being taken care of properly. For example, recent release, Resistance Burning Skies, that was a first-person shooter on Vita. That was our first kind of major game release there. And that game really kind of bombed. It didn't really do all that well, and it was basically not good. I mean, to put it lightly. The game was quite poor. But what the only thing that that game actually did prove, if it proved anything, was that twin stick shooters actually can work quite well on the Vita because of those two analog sticks. Despite the game's shortcomings, it actually felt quite good. And it proved the genre has a place for the Vita. So at the very least, we know that Call of Duty could work on Vita. It's just a matter of it actually being executed properly. And I really hope that is the case. But taking another look at that web listing, we also see some placeholder box art, or maybe that's the final box art. We're not entirely sure, but if that is the final box art, well then, really creative, because basically it's still a guy holding a gun, running mysteriously into the distance. We've kind of meticulously seen this ambiguous imagery a few times in previous entries and in other games and from other publishers and developers, so not really creative there. But either way, this is really important for Sony, really important for Vita, and hopefully it actually moves some units, because that's really what we want, is for the Vita to actually sell. And looking further into the horizon for Vita, there's not much else that we can really look at. I mean, we also, in terms of bigger marquee titles, we've also got Assassin's Creed Liberation coming, PlayStation All-Stars Battle Royale, but we need more titles like this for sure. Anyway, that's all I wanted to talk to you guys about, and so I think this is going to be a new series that I'm going to be trying out again called Let's Talk PlayStation. So I'm going to try and do this new show every Friday from here on out, and we'll cover the previous news week of what happened within the world of PlayStation. So we'll round everything up and give a nice little discussion topic, and of course inform you, the viewer, about what's going on in the Sony world. And if you enjoy this, please let me know, and I'll keep doing them. So thank you all for watching this, and I'll see you all in my next video. Take it easy.